The Hare and the Deer. Hey children, do you like Uncle Moon? This story is just about him. Long ago, Uncle Moon used to travel on his chariot in the sky, but that was not pulled by horses, but by a golden, beautiful little reindeer. The deer was unique and beautiful, with big, beautiful horns, with cute little golden yellow dots all over his body. He was Uncle Moon's favorite deer. Uncle Moon used to give him delicious green grass to eat, and the deer was Uncle Moon's favorite. Until one day, as Uncle Moon rode in the Garden of Heaven and saw a special tree, and near the tree was a little white rabbit.
Oh, how cute! Come here, little rabbit.
The rabbit was lovely, with soft white fur. His eyes were red and glowing. At first, the rabbit was startled by the sound of Uncle Moon and the deer, and so he hid himself behind the garden tree. The rabbit's heart was racing, but Uncle Moon treated him kindly and rode back on the chariot to home. And from then on, Uncle Moon pampered him entirely too much, and the rabbit became spoiled. Uncle Moon took him everywhere he went and put him on his lap and his special chariot all the time. And the poor little deer felt neglected. Uncle Moon no longer held him or paid much attention to him, and even left him behind at times. So the deer became jealous of the rabbit, but he could not do anything about it, so he kept quiet. Then it so happened that the deer got tired one day and felt very hungry. So he went down to the garden and started eating the leaves and grasses.
"Hey, deer, what are you doing? Don't you know who owns this garden and that grass?"
The deer was surprised to hear someone, and when he saw that it was the rabbit speaking so harshly, he was very upset. So he faced the rabbit and said,
"What's wrong with you, rabbit? What do you mean, what's wrong? This tree belongs to me, and you're eating my grass." "No, it doesn't. This garden belongs to Uncle Moon, and I am his deer, so I have a right to be here in the garden. Don't you eat those, or I'll slap your face. Don't you dare. You're just a little bunny. And if Uncle Moon finds out about you bullying me, he'll teach you a lesson."
This made the rabbit even more angry. His eyes became more red.
"Ha! Go ahead. I don't care. Tell Uncle Moon." "Rabbit, you're always so cranky and mean. We're both Uncle Moon's pets. I think all the extra attention has made you spoiled and unkind." "Uncle Moon isn't all that great. This garden is so great because of me."
The deer was shocked to hear this, so he left. And the next day, Hare was sitting on the lap of Uncle Moon when the deer came inside and said,
"Uncle Moon, this rabbit has become very rude and arrogant."
"What are you talking about, silly deer?"
"You know what I'm talking about."
"No, I have no idea."
"Uncle Moon, yesterday I was hungry and went to eat in the garden. And this rabbit came and threatened to hit me if I didn't stop eating."
"He threatened to hit you? Rabbit, is that true?"
"Yes, he was eating beside my special tree in my garden." "Uncle Moon, it's not his garden. Isn't it your garden?"
"Yes, it belongs to me."
"Well, Rabbit said the garden was so beautiful all because of him."
Listening to all this, Uncle Moon got very angry.
"Rabbit, is that true? Did you say that to my deer?"
Yes, I did, and it's true. The garden is bright because of me, and that's why you take me everywhere with you.
Uncle Moon became very, very angry and threw the rabbit out of his lap.
Rabbit, you are arrogant and rude. I should never have given you so much. Go away from here.
Eventually, the rabbit understood that it was his fault. One day, the deer came to speak with him.
See what happens when you become so arrogant and mean? You get hungry and banished from the garden. Oh, dear friend, why are you talking to me like this? I have understood my fault, and I'm feeling very bad about it. I miss you, and I miss you and Uncle Moon. I want you to come there again.
Deer felt very sympathetic about Hare.
Dear Hare, do you actually feel sorry about what you did? Okay, then, don't cry now. I'll talk to Uncle Moon. Come on with me to Uncle Moon.
Deer took Hare to the Uncle Moon.
Uncle Moon! Uncle Moon! I met Hare on the earth!
So what?
Poor guy. He's in a very bad situation.
That's what he deserves.
No, Uncle Moon. Remember how you loved having him as your pet? Don't you feel bad for him?
Look, dear, arrogant people must have consequences.
But Uncle Moon, he has had his consequences. Please have mercy on him.
Okay, if you say so, I will. Call him over.
So the deer ran to find the rabbit and brought him to Uncle Moon. Uncle Moon felt compassion for the crying rabbit, so he picked him up and put him on his lap and said,
Look, rabbit, you became spoiled with my love and you should not have been so arrogant and mean. A person should be honest and humble and kind to others. Because the deer has asked me to have mercy, I have reconsidered and you can live here with us. And come with me on the night of the full moon and live in the garden.
And from then on, Uncle Moon started to take the rabbit with him whenever the moon was full, and the deer on all the other days. Have you seen them, children? No? Then go look at the moon tonight and see if you can see the deer or the rabbit. The end.